In a briefing with President Marcos Thursday, MMDA Chairman Romando Artes says floods in most parts of Metro Manila have subsided, except for some areas in the cities of Malabon and Navotas. Let's get more updates. Joining us in top stories, the MMDA Chairman himself, Romando Artes. Mr. Chairman, good afternoon. Thank you very much for talking to us.
Good afternoon, Ron, and to your viewers.
I was supposed to ask you about any other areas that remain flooded and impassable, but it seems it's just Malabon and Navotas that seem to have a problem still, sir?
Malabon, Navotas, Valenzuela, Marikina, and some parts of Quezon City actually still have areas that are flooded right now.
And A number of roads still impassable in those areas that you mentioned, sir?
Yes, there are some roads that are still impassable in those areas. But there are reasons for the flood existing in those areas, particularly in Botas and Malabon because of the damage na navigational gate. If you will recall, a ship rammed into our navigational gate, causing damage. We cannot put it in a close, 100% closed position. That's why during high tide, water will come in from Manila Bay into Malabon and Navotas. Insofar as Valenzuela is concerned, water coming released from Angat and Ipo, as well as waters coming down from Quezon City and Caloocan, remained in Venezuela because it's currently high tide. Even if we pump the water out to Manila Bay, still it will go back through the river system. In Quezon City, there are some portions that are still flooded, but it's receding as we speak. Marikina, the same, Ron.
Right. About those pumping stations, from what I know, there are about more than 70 pumping stations. There are 71 from the MMDA, pumping stations from the MMDA. And this was raised yesterday when I was monitoring social media and people were asking about it. And I do want to ask you directly, sir, were they all operational?
Yes, they were all operational except one in the afternoon. We have a pumping station in Libertad in Pasay. It's being upgraded by DPWH. Unfortunately, it caught fire. The cause is still being investigated by BFP, Bureau of Fire. But as we speak, they are assessing the damage and we'll make sure it will be operational soon. But however, 71 pumping stations were operational during the height of the storm. I'd just like to emphasize, Ron, that the volume of water monitored by our Weather Bureau exceeded that of Ondoy. Ondoy, in a 24-hour period, only brought about 455 millimeter of rain. For Typhoon Karina, it's 466, I think.
Right.
So it exceeded the Ondoy level. Lucky for us, the release of the water from the dam is very minimal. In fact, La Mesa, I think, did not overflow. So in terms of rain or volume of water that was brought by Karina, it's more than the Ondoy. So it's not that our pumps are not working, but right, it's really the volume of water.
And we saw them working when the floods that we saw yesterday somehow immediately subsided or at a faster rate than before, right?
Yes, that's the proof that our pumping stations are working. Because even the mayors were reporting to us during our monitoring yesterday, that 2-3 hours after the rain stopped, the water immediately receded.
Mr. Chairman, with this, okay, it was the volume. It was not about the pumping stations, if they were working properly or not. It was the volume of rain that we received from Typhoon Karina. But what does this mean now? Do we need more pumping stations in anticipation of more weather disturbances that could bring in more rain than Karina?
Yes, we really need more pumping stations. It should be positioned or placed in critical areas. As we speak, we are currently upgrading most of our pumping stations through DPWH. It's a World Bank funded project. Existing pumps are being increased in capacity. New ones are being created or constructed. So we're doing it right now, the upgrade. And what we're looking at are data that will somehow, that our pumping station will have the capacity 10, 20 years from now.
Right.
That will be able to pump out the water even 10, 20 years from now.
Okay. Now, from floods, the MMDA has now moved to clearing debris from the roads, and we saw tons of garbage, sir, in several areas.
Yeah.
Please tell us, how are the clearing operations going?
We're helping LGUs to clear up flooded roads because you see in the pictures, you can see in the pictures that after the water subsided, a lot of garbage were left on the street. So we're cleaning it up, helping LGUs clean up. We have equipment and personnel to do that, but NCR is quite big, so we're really more on assisting LGUs in this cleanup operation.
I'm curious, sir, which areas the MMDA had the most problem with regard to the clearing of garbage?
Well, Marikina, for one, there are a lot of garbage, but it's not garbage from Marikina.
Yeah.
Mostly from upstream, being going with the flow of the water and being stuck in Marikina. I think the area I'm breathing on right now. The Dolomite Beach also, we are cleaning it up now. There are also a lot of garbage in that area.
Okay, MMDA Chairman. MMDA Chairman Romando Artes, thank you very much, sir, for taking time to talk to us. Thank you.